Hey there, YouTube. Every year we have a annual Halloween party in our basement. It's a creepy kind of basement, so it usually works out really well. Thought I'd throw it on YouTube this year to give an idea, others ideas for doing a creepy circus or a carnival type party. So I'll just do a walkthrough now, part one, and part two I'll show you with the lighting effects. Not really looking for any critiques on our party, just putting this out there for anyone to look for ideas, as I found it a little difficult to find other home Halloween party ideas for circus themes. So what you're looking at now, and I know there's a glare, it's a puzzle that my mother put together on circus kind of animals and toys and stuff like that, something she found at a thrift store. So it was a little creepy ad that we used. So balloons, definitely a good idea. We were having some bad luck with balloons. They kept popping, so we gave up on that. I have an unused BioCube aquarium, and I went on to eBay, I think it was, and I found mannequin heads for $5 a piece. They come all white. My wife is good at painting, so she painted the face on our dummy. It's just base, like, tan spray paint, and then acrylic paint used for the eyes and makeup and stuff like that. And we had this wig sitting around as well as the bandana. So we just threw her in there and we got a whole bunch of neon paper, cheap, that we put on signs. And in the black light they show up really well. So we just gave her a name. We have a little fortune pulling bin. And, you know, I created probably about 36 or so different sayings. None of them are really good fortunes, to kind of add to the amusement of it. So that's our fortune teller telling lady. We have our dead flying trapezist. It's basically just PVC pipe with the T connectors on each end, some rope I had laying around that we stapled up to the beams of the ceiling. We had that old garter, whatever you call that thing, from a costume from previous years, so I threw that on her. We used a lot of fishing line, because it creates a transparent way to put things in directions that they normally don't fit. The skeleton I think I got from Spirit of Halloween last year for $20. It's one of the snap-together ones. It's a cheaper kind, and a couple of the nubs had broken off last year, so I used twine to kind of tie the pieces together, fixing it. And I don't know if you can see the fishing line holding her up. So just an idea. And again, we have the sign, the flying trapeze Lena. We use tarps to cover off our areas where we don't want people to go. We use Dollar Tree tablecloths. $1 a piece. Everything at the Dollar Tree is $1 or 2 for a dollar. We used a lot of those. This area here yet needs to get covered up. But we also have a balloon game. It's called the Balloon-O-Rama, but the things are being covered up. Just a bunch of Dollar Tree balloons. A whole pack. I think there were like 32 variety balloons for a dollar. I put some snacks and prizes in some. I have a dart that I need to hang up yet, and cloths that I put up behind this so no one can see the washer and the furnace and all that stuff. But you just start popping balloons and you get a prize. This guy here is my wife's idea. He's our fire breather. Plug him in quick. Last year we had bought two strings of the fire twinkling lights. So you see both strands here, one the ball out of the mouth and here the torch that he's holding. And it's just a thrift store Grim Reaper outfit that I bought for a dollar a couple years ago. We got the mask at Menards for, I think, $7 on clearance this year. And she just wrapped them all together, so it's a pretty neat effect. Last year I created the jail cell here. That's all out of PVC pipe. Probably at most cost $10 to make. And then I used some gray spray paint to fully cover it, and some black spray paint to kind of give it an older look. So we just have some little items on there. Here's Sloth, if everyone's familiar with the Goonies. We have a bucket of Rocky Road with him there. And he's got a baby Ruth in his hand. I see his name is Sloth. I sit in my electrical chair that I made a couple years ago. Can't really see the electric chair all that well. But it's got straps on it, and he's positioned to look like he's trying to break out. This would be the electrocution hat, or whatever, which is just an old bendy light from a thrift store attached to the electric chair. Okay. Each one of our guys here, this is our freak show area, has a little tip area. We have a two-headed man. The skulls are from one of the Halloween stores. I think they're $4 or $5 a piece, put together with a dummy body, and he becomes our two-headed man. We have a skin. I call him the Skin Side Out Man. Just another freak within our show here. He's chained, as well as our two-headed man is chained. Then we have a fun house. So out of cardboard and some aluminum foil type stuff with some fun duct tape that my wife has. She made a fun house sign. So we'll go into our fun house. Here we have pool noodles hanging. They're hanging by fishing line, and we have a few back lights in here to make everything kind of pop. I used our iPad to take pictures of ourselves and then distort them to make kind of goofy pictures to hang up. We couldn't really find a whole lot of well mirrors to use in here, so we didn't do that. We put the neon paper on the floor to kind of give that visual stimuli. These white claws that you might see all over, they're actually from a thrift store. They come from a local hospital. Sounds gross. They are used, but I'm sure they bleach them, and then I bleach them a couple times before we actually use them. And we are lucky to have these old clown faces that my wife painted with acrylic paint, so they show up really well. Okay. Again, using the Dollar Tree covers, or table covers, we block that area off to kind of keep some of the light out. So we have our snack area, tablecloths, and some tin foil type wrapping paper we use just to cover our walls. We also used the tablecloths from the Dollar Tree to make it look like we're inside of a tent. So this is the one tent, and that's the main tent. It's covered up as best we can. We have our little creepy midget clown, sorry, dwarf clown or little person clown. We have our puppets. We have carnival prizes, a little dunk tank, my clown guy that I made, our snacks and food, and then we found cotton candy at the Dollar Tree again, and stacked them up so that people can pull them off like at a real carnival. Party's not until tomorrow, so there's no food out. Almost done. We have our Not-So-Houdini, man trapped in the box, and the mime that I made, getting caught in the act cutting up, or about to cut up the man in the box. So again, we made the stage out of Dollar Tree tablecloths. And there's the only attendant. They've obviously been here for a while. Using crepe paper, it's kind of an entryway into what we call just our little living room area by our bar. We have the knife throw, I don't know what they're called, but the guy that's getting knives thrown at them. Out of beer cases and old Christmas wrapping paper, I made this little gate, and it's our escape lion. My chow and border collie will be wearing a lion's mask, so the idea is she's escaped and she's man-eating, so you gotta watch out for her. And that head right there is an unfortunate victim of the man-eating lion. So that's it. That is our exterior. I do have a ticket booth yet. Unfortunately, I'm using an iPhone. I can't pause it. You have to watch me walk out to the garage. But we had an old recliner chair chair box that we made into a ticket booth. It's pretty standard, those I've seen quite a bit online. So check back for part two and I'll show you the lighting.